today we are going to start with the chapter 100 dresses. As this chapter, it is published, it is in the two forms, that is 100 dresses 1 and 100 dresses 2. Both are in sequence with each other. But both these chapters, it holds very deep view. It is one of my favorite chapter. Means as you read, you will feel that you are flowing with the feelings of the girls. It is you, people will also relate yourself with the characters of this chapter. As this chapter, it is related to your school life. Many things are mentioned here in this chapter, which you feel, yes, this happens in our class also. Yes, we people do this kind of thing. So, first of all, what is the atmosphere of the class? You people have attended number of classroom sessions since your class nursery till your class 9. Now, can you tell what kind of environment, exists in your classroom? Not in the presence of teacher, but in the absence of teacher. What do you people do? Just a general question. Nothing I have to judge about it. I just want to relate it to the chapter. Yes, who will tell me what kind of classroom environment prevails in the absence of teacher? What do you people do? Yes, who will tell me? Raise up your hand. Bhavna, can you tell me what usually students do when the teacher is not present in the class?
Ma'am, yes, there are many class clowns which make the environment quite joyful.
Make your things joyful. And what kind of relationship that exists between students? How they behave with each other? Tell me.
Ma'am, there are many faces in the classroom. Like sometimes there are the children get very naughty and they do mischievous things in the class.
Yes, doing mischievous things. And many times do you feel that people are often taking, you can say, false name, nicknames of the others in order to tease others? This also happens?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Has ever this kind of thing happened with any child, that other children, they are teasing that child too much, and ultimately what has happened, the child starts crying?
Yes, ma'am.
This happens. This is common behavior of the children, that they tease, for example, that this, when you can say group of children, they are teasing only one child, and ultimately, yes, what the other child will do? Nothing. The other child will feel so helpless that he has no way other than crying. And then Bhavna, what the other children will do? They all become silent. Am I right, Bhavna? Yes. She's saying yes. Then the class, it turns out to be silent. But have you ever felt that if you are teasing a child and when the class fell silent, is anybody repenting again upon the act and not doing the same thing again? This happens, Anshika? People feel, yes, I'm wrong. I will not.
Yes, ma'am.
This happens. It means that why we go to that extent to tease any child to that extent that we hurt the feelings of others? It means that at some of the points we feel ourselves that we are not human beings. We feel ourselves that we have the right to violate the law of living of others. We sometimes go to that extent in teasing that we forget, yes, the other person also feels. If someone is lacking something, or someone is, you can say, in your eyes you feel that someone is not up to the mark, that doesn't mean that human being is not right. It doesn't mean that human being is not at all right. He is of course a human being. He too has his aspirations. He too has his feelings. He too has his, individuality, which the child feels that should not be curtailed from him. So a sensible child never makes fun of anyone. Am I right? He's always thinking,
yes,
or a sensible child is always telling the others, no, please stop this. you are doing wrong thing. But sometimes the children, they flow in their own thoughts to that extent that they violate the behavior of others. They violate the law of living. They violate their, you can say, right of living. You tease, sometimes you tease a child so much that next day, sometimes he is getting absent or he is coming with his parents into the school. Yes, so and so child is disturbing me. So and so child is teasing me. Sometimes this also resulted in fights outside the school. This is also one case. Yes, this happens also.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, also sometimes there happen some fights. Sometimes some groupism is there. And ultimately you are a part of that group, and ultimately you realize that in that groupism I have done this wrong. My parents would not approve my this act. And when your parents come to know, sometimes when your teacher comes to know, you people are feeling so ashamed that you are not able to raise up your eyes even. And then what happens? At that moment you realize, this is what this chapter is all about. Having a long name is not an insulting remark for anybody. In this chapter, the girl Wanda Petrowski, who was a Polish girl, she has a unique name, and for that name, she's always being, insulted, always being tortured by the other two, by the other children. Mainly, the two names are that we have to read about these two girls are Maddie and Peggy. Maddie's full name is Madeline, and no doubt they are bad girls. No, not at all. In this chapter, we will read that Peggy, she was quite intelligent girl, topper of the class, and she is going to be expected to top the drawing competition also, because everyone knew she is so popular in the school. She is having a very good hand in copying the various characters, the various, you can say, images. She is so talented. And ultimately, Maddie, who is not able to disclose her feelings, who is not able to make Peggy understand that what she is doing is wrong. She is also a part in her crime of teasing Wanda Petrowski. She is also teasing. Why they are teasing Wanda Petrowski? They were teasing just because daily she is wearing just one dress. Daily she is wearing just one dress, that is the faded blue dress. And daily, because she is wearing the one dress, and she is coming from an area, from a dwelling place, which is, which is full of mud. Not rich people were living there. And moreover, when she is coming to school, her feet are covered with mud. So this is the reason. Is it a crime that you belong not to a rich family? Is it a crime? No. It's not a crime. Moreover, it's not a kind of discrimination that God has made. God has never made rich and poor. God has never developed caste. Who are we? We are actually the creators of all this. We have segregated people on various, you can say, various realms, on the basis of various things, on the basis of various regions. He's from America, he's from Australia, he's from Pakistan. He's from this community, from that community. It means that we are separated from each other on the basis of what? On the basis of countries also. Then afterwards, we are separated from each other on the basis of religion also. Right? He's Chinese, he's Sikh, he's Muslim, he's Hindu. And on the basis of it, various kinds of religions are formulated, because there are different kind of religions, and ultimately we used to see some other people like with the eye, like with that, you can say, feeling in our eyes that we are not approving them. Who is making these discriminations? We people only, nobody else. In this chapter also, Wanda Petrowski, because she is a Polish girl, And Polish people, they are immigrating only. Immigrated to an to one, it's a community who has immigrated, and it is because of the reason they are not well settled. They are trying to settle them, settle themselves up. And because of this reason, they were not so rich. And Venda, she is belonging to that family. And have you ever imagined that if a child is being tortured in the class, is being ill-treated in the class, he is always being insulted by his classmates, what is the condition of the parents when they would come to know that this kind of behavior is faced by my child in the class? What would be the first reaction of the parents? Can anybody tell? If they come to know that my child is facing this problem. Yes. Who will tell that what will happen? Yes, Anshika. What the parents will feel? Madhav is saying they will feel sad. Of course they will feel sad, but what action they will take?
They will take some kind of strict action against their child, and they will try to make their child learn that they should not do that same task again.
Okay, they will take strict action. But there what kind of strict action?
By scolding them.
By they will try to make the child understand that.
That what?
Ma'am, the parents might be trying to make them understand the child.
Okay.
And there is no difference between rich and poor.
They will try to make the child understand that whatever behavior they are showing to their child is absolutely wrong. They will try to solve it in on their own level. But see, some parents, they are also too you can say too full of feelings. They are too sentimental too, that they take such a strong action to withdraw their child, to withdraw their children from the school also. This happened in this chapter. That Venda Pentronsky, she was facing such kind of discrimination, insult every day. And you know that each and every child is going at home, and he is also discussing with his parents that what has happened to him in the class. Sometimes he is so filled up to the brim because of that kind of ill behavior, ill treatment in the school, that he is on the verge of crying. He is somehow stopping his tears to come out of the eyes. But as soon as the child reaches home, he is overflowed by his feelings. He starts crying. Naturally, the child will tell the parents, first of all, the parents, what they will do. They will tell the child, don't worry, tomorrow it will be fine. You have to face this problem in this manner. You are very strong. You will face them. You will reply them back. You will tell the teacher. But when everything fails, every other, you can say, option, it fails, then ultimately what happens? Then ultimately what will happen? The parents, they will think that there is no other option left except to withdraw our child from the school. And this is what that has happened. Venda Pentronsky's father, he has come to know that my girl, that my little girl, she is facing so much of insult in the school. And ultimately one day, without informing anybody, he has withdrawn Venda Pentronsky from the school along with her younger brother. That was too shocking for the teacher. When the part of the teacher will come, you will feel, yes, this is happening in our classes also. And ultimately what happened? That was really very shocking, and more, you can say, pinpointing for Maddie and Peggy, as without any intimation, Venda was withdrawn from the school. They were feeling ashamed of their behavior. They were trying to finally repent it back. They were trying to improve their behavior, but sometimes when one chance is lost, everything is lost. Sometimes you don't get a chance to make your mistake correct. You don't get a chance to recorrect yourself. So ultimately, we don't do such kind of things. We don't have to indulge ourselves in those things which we never make correct again, which we never feel that we should do it again. This happened with Maddie and Peggy. So ultimately, why Wanda was insulted by others? Does anybody know that what kind of girl Wanda was? No, nobody knew that. She has feelings. Moreover, she has the quality of good drawing. When the drawing competition held in the school, everybody was guessing, even Maddie was guessing that Peggy would win the competition. But no, ultimately who won the competition? It was Wanda Petrowski who has won the competition. She won the competition and ultimately she was not there to receive the winning certificate because her father has withdrawn her from the school just because of the insult that she is always meting out in the class. It is because of that behavior that she is facing every day. So it means that this chapter, it also describes the judgmental nature of the people. That people are too judgmental in their ways. If we see a person, we immediately pass on judgment. Yes, he's like that. He's like this. If a new child enters the class, we immediately pass on the judgments. Yes, aisa hi hoga ye. But how can we pass judgments? Who has given us the right to pass on the judgments? Nobody has given us the right. It means that people are too judgmental in their nature. But we should always remember this, that we should never judge a book by its cover. Book can never be judged by its cover until and unless you read it properly. So Maddie and Peggy, they have read Wanda from outside. They were asking her again and again that how many dresses she has. She is always telling 100 dresses in my wardrobe or in my almira, all lined up in a row. But daily she is wearing only one dress, that is the faded blue dress. This is the reason why Peggy was asking her again and again. Whenever they were playing in the recess, they would, group of girls would say, headed by Peggy to Wanda, okay Wanda, how many dresses you have? And Wanda would say 100 dresses lined up. And they would start laughing at her. And Wanda, she's not replying back. She's not giving an answer. Just tight-lipped girl. But inside her, she has a storm of feelings. She has so deep feelings that she's really feeling that, yes, they are insulting me. Though she did not have those 100 dresses, but in her imagination, she has those 100 dresses. And when the drawing competition was held, she has made those pictures of 100 dresses that she was having in her imagination. And ultimately, the two beautiful dresses she has given to Peggy and Maddie in the form of drawing. So this chapter, it also highlights the discrimination that is being conducted by people on the basis of caste, because she's from Polish community, who is an immigrant one, which is not given approval by the people of their community. She is coming from Bogen's Height, which was highly situated on the top of a mountain where the roads were not properly built up. And every day she is coming to school, her feet are usually covered with mud. This is also one of the reasons that why she is made fun of. And then bullying, the main topic which is going to be highlighted, the main theme which the writer wants to bring in here in this chapter is that of bullying. That bullying is a part, it is going to be, or it has turned to be a part of school life also. And ultimately, many children, they are facing this kind of behavior, and because of that, their feelings are hurt. They feel so sad that they find themselves broken in their hearts, in their feelings. And ultimately what happens? Ultimately it happens that they feel themselves as low. They don't compare themselves with others. And in the long run of life, that you can say that bullying, it stays with them. That is always diminishing their confidence. not help, it is not helping them to build up their confidence. And this is what has happened with Brenda Pentronsky. I told you, this is one of my favorite chapters in all the school books that I have ever read. So beautifully expressed by the writer, the feelings of Brenda, and ultimately it is so much related to school life that it is teaching us an important lesson. So with you, I'm sharing the chapter that is going to be visible on your screens. So here it is. How do we judge the people around us? By their money, wealth, and possessions? Yes. This has turned out to be our way of living, that we used to judge people's. How? On the basis of wealth, possessions. People don't like to talk with others who are not wealthy, who are not having so much of worldly possessions, that they feel that they are not of our standard. Yes, Vanshika, you want to say anything? So, this has turned out to be our criteria. But as I told you, that has God ever made this criteria? No. It is we human beings that we have created those margins and we have created those segregations. And ultimately, we people are doing all this kind of discrimination. Or is there something of more enduring value to look for in a person? What is more important to look in a person? Is it only money? Is it only wealth to see in a person? No. It's not like that, only money and wealth that is going to be seen in a person. I don't think so. It's only the qualities that should be admired for. It should be the qualities that are always to be acknowledged. We must look for the good qualities of a person. Rather, judging the person on the basis of worldly possessions, those great people who have turned out to be great personalities, are they all born with silver spoon? No. They were not at all born with silver spoon. They were not at all so rich. But ultimately what has happened? They have proved themselves, they have proved their mettle just because of their qualities. So it is not the quality of the child. Sorry, it is not only the money or the worldly possessions that are to be admired, but actually the good qualities in a person's character that will always leave an unremovable mark in everybody's mind. So, this story is a sensitive account of how a poor young girl is judged by her classmates. This I have very well explained to you. Brenda Pentronsky is a young Polish girl who goes to a school with other American children in an American town. I told you, because Polish people, they were the immigrants. So American people, they have not approved them. And Brenda is different in many ways. Can you guess how they treat her? So this is how they were treating her. Read the information in the box below. Find out more about this community for about a related topic from an encyclopedia or the internet. So here is it is written, the Polish-American community in the United States. See, the first Polish immigrants arrived in America in 1608. So when the first Polish community arrived in America, it arrived in 1608. But the largest wave of Polish immigration occurred in the early 20th century. But when the greatest number of people started fleeing towards America, it was in 1608, when more than 1 million Poles migrated to the United States. During this time, large number of people in very large number, they have immigrated to United States. The Polish state did not exist at that time. Yes, there was no Polish state at that time. And the immigrants were identified according to their country of origin rather than to ethnicity. Means, yes, they were identified, they were discriminated only on the basis of their origin. from where they are rather than to the actual or to the unique values of their culture. No. They were identified as Russian Poles, German Poles, and Austrian Poles. And on this basis, they were differentiated at all. One of the most notable Polish-American communities is in Chicago and its suburbs. Suburb means when the main town it is into its units. So, one of the main Polish-American community where it is in Chicago. Chicago is sometimes called the second largest Polish city in the world, next to Warsaw, the capital of Poland. Means after Poland, here it is in Chicago, that number of people, they have immigrated from Poland, and this is one of the greatest Polish community, right? So, Polish Americans were sometimes discriminated against in the United States, as were the Irish, Italians, and Jews. Yes, I told you that people were discriminated. So, according to United States 2000 census, 667,414 Americans of age 5 years and older reported Polish as the language spoken at home. So, these are the figures given, that number of people they were speaking Polish, and which is about 1.4% of the people who speak languages other than English. So it's a large number, that how many people they have immigrated from Poland to America, or 0.25% of the US population. So naturally, you have heard about Nelson Mandela chapter, we have read. There also discrimination was there. Africans and Americans. Discrimination between the white and the black. Policy of apartheid. Why? Just on the basis of color. This discrimination, it persists even today. Although by law it is abolished, but still many people, they have faced this kind of discrimination. So ultimately, those people, they are not letting any other community to enter into there so easily. And this is what we are going to read in the chapter. So tomorrow we will start with the chapter here. And I hope that you will enjoy this chapter a lot. Very, very beautiful chapter. I can't express it in words that how much or how deep feelings this chapter is holding. It's very, very great chapter. Too much touching to your heart, and you will enjoy. And from the examination point of view also, definitely question in the long question you will expect. And with this, we are going to end. Tomorrow we will start the reading of the chapter.